agent-based simulation is often used for things like looking at traffic flow and traffic management or evacuation scenarios. So it's very simple to model cars keeping a certain distance from each other or people following other people in a crowd. But the kind of behavior you get in a flooding scenario or many of these scenarios is much more complex than that. So one of the things that's really unique in the simulation work that the RMIT group does is that we focus a lot on cognitive agents rather than simple agents.
We're built on former swampland and reclaimed land, so we're prone to flooding, and we're now starting to look at what that might mean when we combine it with future climate change elements such as sea level rise.
So we're working with the City of Port Phillip and the SES, and the aim is to try and use technology like agent-based simulation to try and understand how people respond to flooding events, and then try and capture this into a simulation and then try and inform policy and planning around that.
The RMIT research being undertaken will consolidate and utilise our data and our flood maps and allow us to identify what are those real issues in the Elwood Canal and I guess practically apply that and work with the community better.
So the project is funded by the National Climate Change Adaptation Framework under their Emergency Management Program. In Elwood, we're looking at whether sandbagging might help in mitigating the effects of flooding. So we're looking at, well, would sandbagging depots help? Is there enough warning time? Or is there likely to be enough warning time? How many depots would you need? How many houses would you save? That sort of thing.
When you're looking at the simulation, you've got the map of Elwood, so you can see dots that go around. They are the people who are driving, and they change color based on what they're doing. So ideally, you can imagine a system where you can just plug in any suburb and any sort of behaviors and be able to do similar analysis.
The reason why this is useful for us, and it's useful all around, is the results of something like that, we can communicate very well with the community if it's a simulation tool. It allows demonstration easily, it allows people to comprehend and arrive at a starting point for dialogue at a much more level playing field.
This technology is extremely general, and there's many, many applications in climate change adaptation, in emergency management, in a whole range of areas, because really it's the technology that we're working on and then applying it to things, and it's a very, very powerful technology.
It's really good to see technology and IT being used in other domains. And I think that's where the real value is for technology, really, is to help people do things.